Hi everyone, sorry for the noise. I'm making a Dovetail box. You'll see some methods I use. And these are pretty typical things that everyone does. All woodworkers do. So right now I'm marking with a knife. Get a perfect knife line. And the reason I'm doing this way is because I'm using a very thin stock, and if I were to do one by one, I would not have that balance. So with two together, I'm getting pretty decent results. Just lining them up. This is the inside of the box, so I can go full cut with my knife. Although it's better if you practice going one by one for your cut. But I do it for special reason. I want to identify which side is the front, which side is the back. So I'm just going to go lightly. It's the same on the other side. Let me check if you can see. Yeah, I think you can see. So what I end up with is a knife line going all the way around. in the car with the coping saw, staying away from my knife line. Quarter inch chisel just to clean out the inside parts. Made a mistake. Let's see how it's going to look when we assemble it. Thank you. just lining up these lines here. I'm making a small, wait a minute, here. I'm gonna make a small piercing with the tip of the knife. So, okay, then I'm gonna run them from one point to the other. Now, transfer these lines to the back side. I'm using the corner of the chisel just to clean up the very bottom where my saw didn't cut fully. Just lightly. I'm not pressing hard. I'm just going very, very lightly. Okay. Here I'm just working around the saw curve. Making like 2-3 degree angle here, and not fully, it's only starting from away from the tape here, from this corner in. Okay. Very, very lightly, very gently. Hope it works. Thank you. want to make sure that these are fully seated. Otherwise, they may break. Okay. So this is first cut. As you can see. Okay, let's move on to the others. So maybe you see here, I have a line. Let me show it to you. So in here, these lines have been transferred from this. Okay. So a lot of people make mistakes by going right on the line and making their cut. The correct way of doing this is to stay away from the line into the cut where you're going to remove, which means this part and that part. And you also should consider the thickness, the set of the saw what you're using. If the set is high, if it's coarse, then don't be fooled. Sorry to say it like that, but you need to consider that, and you need to stay away from it so that when you're cutting away totally right up against the line. So let me show you. Okay. Sorry, I'm alone here, and I'm the only cameraman and the woodworker. We all make mistakes. It's not like end of the world, and it's not like that happens when you're having a gap. It's always a practice, believe me. Of course, you feel bad about it. There's no question about it. But don't feel too bad. You can make a new one. To locate the knife line. There we go. Thank you. We need to mark here. Okay, one more to go. that's how it's done. You can see. And then I'm just going to glue them up and it's ready. Thank you, everyone.